In Rio de Janeiro, you can have 15, 14 shootings per day.
The police were raiding an alleged drug den in what turned into one of the state's deadliest operations to date.
There are lots of people living here, but that doesn't do anything to lessen the fighting.
People are afraid of being hit by a stray bullet in the street.
Commuters caught in the crossfire, the city's metro descending into chaos.
You can see shooting with people dead.
Disputes between gangs and paramilitary, a lot of police raids, a lot of shootings.
How can you understand what's going on if you don't have information about it? Who has been killed? The age, the gender, the race. We have to hold the government responsible for what they are doing or what they are not doing. Not producing information is also part of the problem. My name is Cecilia Oliveira. I am a journalist and I am a founder and executive director at Instituto Fogo Cruzado. The Instituto Fogo Cruzado has an app that tracks and maps every shooting and shootout that occur in almost 50 cities in Brazil.
It's the biggest database about this issue in Latin America.
The app Fogo Cruzado works in this way. When someone is just walking around the city and can see a shooting, this person can send us the information through the app or through the social media. It was a teenager that was pregnant and was hit by a bullet on a belly. And we can check this information and then we release the information. We can see information about a shooting that has someone injured, and it was a police raid. When you have the red ones, it means that someone died. The federal government, they don't produce information about homicides. I could see my friends saying, I was going to work and I saw something. I was going to take my kids from the school and I saw something. The subway was suspended because it has a shooting. This was just my friends. So I could understand also that reality, it was worse than that.
We have already mapped 539 shootings in 2023.
We are operating since 2016. Brazil was on the spot because the games were here. I was watching the news. That Rio de Janeiro that everybody was seeing was not the real one. Government wants everybody to see Rio de Janeiro as a wonderful capital, a place to tourists, a very safe city. But in fact, with our data, we can show that the government is failing in protect their people and keep the people safe.
Armed groups, many of them drug traffickers, operate freely in most of the city's 1,000 favelas.
In Rio de Janeiro, we have more than 50 gangs battling around the country. But we also have a lot of paramilitary groups fighting against these gangs.
This is the metropolitan area of Rio de Janeiro. These blue areas, they are ruled by the paramilitary groups organized by cops. This was Rio 10 years ago, and this is Rio today.
Everybody knows the paramilitary guys are corrupt, killing people.
The militias torture, steal, traffic, and because they are composed of police officers or former police officers, the police do not face them as they should.
Police in Brazil are facing international criticism.
This BOPE operation did lead to the arrest of a drug dealer, but it also injured three others and killed a mother of three who was caught in the crossfire on her way to work.
Here in Rio de Janeiro, we have four massacres a month. And in three of these, you have police involvement. In these years, we have two of the biggest massacres involving police in the Rio de Janeiro story. So in two police raids, the police of Rio de Janeiro killed almost 60 people. Police it's more violent in neighborhoods that are poor and has more black people.
People in the favelas are thought as enemies. So when a policeman enters a favela, they don't think it is entering a neighborhood with citizens.
One of the closest and most polarizing elections in the largest country in Latin America.
Lula was met with cheers from his supporters in his stunning defeat of incumbent Jair Bolsonaro.
We want to believe that gun violence and shootings will improve under Lula. As soon as he took the office, he revoked the decrees on weapons approved by Bolsonaro, which released a large amount of weapons and ammunition to civilians.
Bolsonaro has been one of the most polarizing figures in the country's history,
signing a decree that lets more Brazilians buy guns.
The Bolsonaro family's relationship with militia goes back many years.
Every election year, you can have a number of political people that is getting murdered, is getting injured. I lost a friend that was also a congresswoman here, Marielle Franco.
Como a gente diz na favela, o bicho tá pegando lá fora. Então, nós somos contrários ao armamento letal e não letal.
She was fighting very hard against the paramilitary gangs, and this was why she was so well known, but also why she was a target.
Registradas pelo circuito interno, mostram Marielle Franco horas antes de ser assassinada na semana passada, junto com o motorista Anderson Gomes.
She was in the center of Rio when a car came close to her car and killed her and her driver. I was working in Fogo Cruzado that night, so I was the person that was responsible to release that information.
Foram 13 disparos a uma distância de 2 metros. 4 atingiram Marielle na cabeça.
It was very hard to release this information, but when you work in this field, unfortunately, you can know people that are victim. So I lost a friend in this situation. I had other friends that were injured.
It's the scale of the violence that beggars belief. You have to remind yourself that this isn't actually a war zone.
Someone has to work to keep the government accountable. I can point the finger and say, you are killing people.